I'm here with Tim Putman as we get ready for this week's game against Frostburg State University. And first, let's look back at last week's game. The offensive line in the first half really gave Brandon Wray a lot of room to work with.
Yeah, I feel like we played pretty well overall. I mean, we've been working together all summer throughout the spring, had a good camp. I feel like we played pretty well, but there's always room for improvement.
So a lot of new parts in this offensive line. Three new starters this year. You're one of them. Talk about the cohesiveness of the unit so far.
I mean, me, Brian, and Jeremy Power, we're both sophomores, so I mean, we're all pretty good friends. And Anthony West and Bittner, I feel like throughout camp and throughout the season we've been hanging out, so I mean, pretty good cohesiveness.
What have they been saying to you? What have they been telling you to expect as being an offensive lineman at Wesley College?
I mean, you just got to know what you're doing at all times. You got to play hard, play physical.
The offense obviously takes a shot in this game against Christopher Newport with Shane McSweeney going down. What was the team's initial reaction to the injury?
I mean, of course, anytime anyone gets hurt, it hurts. Just to see anyone get hurt, but we were on the 8-yard line, we had to score, so we had to forget about that and score a touchdown.
Do you think the fact that the scoring play came on the next play maybe helped the confidence of the offense?
Oh, of course, anytime you get in the end zone on the next play, we knew we could still play.
Then Justin Sadelaire comes in. Of course, he handed the ball off in that play, and he plays well. 17 of 31, a couple of dropped passes along the way. Talk about the man that's going to be the new starting quarterback for Wesley.
Well, of course, Justin is a completely different quarterback than Shane. Justin's got a really good arm, very good. If we give him time, I know he can find open receivers. Takes out some of the running options Shane had, but we'll be fine with Justin.
Did you see him already taking control of the offense on the leadership side in the huddle, especially in the second half when you guys knew it was going to be him?
Yeah, as the game went on, as the game progressed, he got a lot better leadership-wise, and throughout practice this week, he's been doing fine.
This week, the conference opener against Frostburg State, a conference rivalry for the last time as they move off to the Empire 8 next year. Talk about what it means to try to go 1-0 in the ACFC.
I mean, we got to do it. There's no really other option other than win, so we'll be fine doing that.
What are you expecting to see defensively from the Bobcats? It's going to make life tough for the front five.
I mean, their defensive line's good. They're big kids, good kids. Especially up the field, good, quick linebackers, and their secondary is real fine.
Well, best of luck this afternoon.
Thank you.